Let's go! Today we are going to play 2v2 match on a beautiful map Century Lithilien in Battle for Middle Earth 1 on the patch 2.22. Everybody is picking random and we are playing with Palindru against Mundo and Arcurisan. And we get to play the Isengard faction. Great!
Who now has the strength to stand against the armies of Isengard and Mordor?
Nobody, Saruman, nobody. Isengard is one of my most favorite factions in the game because of the aggressive playstyle. Isengard is pretty strong. We need to wall check. We are against a good faction. And let's use the first Uruk-hai to grab the settlement and also let's send him forward instantly. This way we can catch the enemy soldiers or peasants before they can reach out to our settlement, which is the early goal of the evil factions in BFME1. You need to make sure to protect yourself. We need one more Uruk-hai and always check what your ally is doing. He might need some assistance, even though Isengard can't really offer too much help early on. We need to try to skill. This map is pretty nice for the evil factions like Isengard and Mordor, and Mordor-Isengard combination is also pretty solid because Mordor can provide so much additional damage and armor leadership, as well as combat experience. Warchant to kill them a bit faster. Let's use the workers to grab the other settlements, and also let's bring the second Uruk-hai now forward just to be able to defend ourselves all the time. Again, when it comes to play against like good factions Gondor and Rohan, I like to play a bit more aggressively with my Isengard faction because I don't want them to have too much time to build an army which can crush our army, because good factions like Gondor and Rohan on a map like this have the mobility advantage. They can hit and run. And that's pretty annoying to deal with. So we will have now in total 3 settlements, which is pretty nice. We have even a settlement possibility number 4 at the top side. Our ally is under attack. We are in a El Clasico matchup, by the way. Good versus evil. I like that so much. Just like in the films. The Hobbit is annoying, so we need to bail. And eventually try to drag the Hobbit, you know? So far, we are doing a good job. We are also able to kill many of these peasants. And as long as we can, you know, keep our lumber mills protected, we should be in a good spot. And my ally did a mistake. The mistake he did was he was picking the Eye of Sauron too soon. Because if you use the Eye of Sauron too soon, your opponent, in this case the Gondor player, might be able to react by picking the Elven Wood from the spellbook, which is not going to only negate all the leadership bonuses you get from the Eye of Sauron, but also provide additional armor leadership for the Gondor soldiers. So with that being said, I'm assuming he's going to lose the farm, but it's fine. Let's put some counter. Many more peasants are coming, okay? We need maybe one. I'm gonna save for the Crossbowman, because Crossbowman is giving us the double XP on the Uruk pit, and this is going to help us out to get the Uruk pit to level 2 a bit sooner, which is quite needed in order to be able to recruit the pikemen. The Uruk pikemen, they are needed in this matchup definitely to deal with the Rohirrim archers, but also the Gondor knights. Look at this annoying guy, he's repairing with all the villages. Alright, we need to try to buy some time. Let's use shieldfall formation. Warchant can be used offensively to take down the farm. There we go. Maybe we can take it down this way. Pressure is always nice. And in this game, I want to also build the Warg pit, because Wargs are quite mobile units, just like the Gondor Knights and Rohirrim. And with them, we can keep fighting for the map control all the time. Oh, what is that? Dude, the last march of the peasants now. What is going on? Okay, we need to... I mean, we will be definitely losing this mill. We can always hit and run micro with the Crossbowman. Never get into the melee range against the peasants, because peasants, once they are in the melee range, can one-shot our Crossbowman in literally a second. Okay, we have taken down the farm. That's pretty good. The mill, unfortunately, we can't protect this one. We need to get now some berserkers on the field, which is pretty nice in this matchup against peasants, at least early on. Again, berserkers are like a early game unit. They have not really big impact on the game once the enemy has like cavalry on the field, you know? But against Mordor, they can be quite efficient when it comes to deal with like a massive spam of orcs. So we were doing a good job. We lost only one mill, which is not the end of the world. We have still two untouched mills. That's all it matters. You know, two mills are enough for the evil factions to scale into the mid to late game. Let's grab this Lamri mill to get our third mill. And again, we need a couple of more furnaces inside the castle. And then we will be building up the warg pit. We also need lords. I mean, we need a lord, actually. You know, lords is always nice. I like to get lords on the field personally a bit earlier. This way I can level them up to level 5. Which will always mean more leadership. And more leadership is always great. The more leadership you have, the stronger your combos, your units are going to become. Remember, Battle for Middle-earth 1 is completely a leadership-based game. That means you can make one single unit so strong that he can take down like 10 units by himself. You can also capture this outpost eventually. We are creeping the goblin lair at the top side. We will get some money from this creep. And after getting the money, we might be able to purchase the outpost. And once again, our ally is in a bad spot. He keeps losing the mills. In this matchup as Mordor against Gondor and Rohan, you will definitely need trolls. Not only because of that, but also you need Dramar trolls to support the Isengard ally with additional armor, damage and combat experience leadership. Let's put them inside, that's good. This way we have some protection for the outpost, which is always great. Build more furnaces, just to get a bit more money, you know? Isengard needs a lot of resources. Can we kill them? These peasants are annoying. And Rohirrim are coming now, please! Oh my goodness, this Gondor Knight! Okay, he will try to trample our Berserker, but we need to micro now with the Berserker get to the pikemen. This way we can potentially protect. Nice. The Rohirrim are now forced to disengage. This is a win-win situation. We killed the peasants and we forced the Rohirrim to go back. I mean, it would be a better situation, of course, if we could kill them, but I'm happy with this result. Now let's recruit the fighting Uruk-hai lords. The most cost-efficient hero in all Battle for Middle-earth games. Just kill those peasants all the time. Put some counter pressure with the Berserkers. They are also dealing a great amount of damage to the enemy structures, if you don't know. With them, you can also take down the enemy farms a little bit faster. Okay, he won't be able to do much. The last spot, we will be saving that for the warg pit. And lords is on the field, and I'm assuming we won't get the chance to kill the Rohirrim, but that's fine. Always build some more towers. I see many people making the mistake to not build enough towers as the evil factions like Isengard and Mordor. There is no reason for you to not build towers. They cost almost nothing. When you have like 2 mills, they will cost less than 150. And they will give you so much safetiness, you know? Which is always nice. Better safe than sorry, as you know. Oh my goodness, please. Buy a slaughterhouse there. Remember in the patch 2.22, we lowered the slaughterhouse price from 300 down to 200 in the outpost. I mean in the settlements outside. We will now use the lords to creep the troll lair. That's going to make our lords to hit level 3, which unlocks the carnage. And carnage is great when it comes to take down enemy heroes like Theorin and Eomer later on. So let's creep this. There we go. Nice. Oh, but it's fine, it's fine. Oh, that's kind of unfortunate. We could almost take it down, but it's fine too. We are buying some time. Everything that we do, which keeps the enemy on their side of the map, is a win-win situation. Not only we are buying some time for ourselves, but also buying some time for our ally, who is losing quite a lot now. But it's fine, we can carry this match. He has also no troll cage. I mean, rushing a Nazgul in this match is not very efficient, because Eowyn from Rohan and Faramir from Gondor, this combination can one-shot a Nazgul from 100 to 0. Warning arrow plus the smite is dealing so much damage. So I personally would recommend to go for the troll cage and get a Dramar troll on the field as soon as possible to just make a move. Because trolls, not only hitting like a truck, but also being able to destroy the enemy wall so we can go inside the genes. But it's fine. Oh, here's the outpost. He might be... I mean, I don't think he can protect this outpost. He has no units inside the outpost. There is no protection. We might send lords eventually to support, but it might be a little bit too late. I mean, as you can see, until we have a great amount of resource income. We need now armor, blades, fire, and also banner from the armory. And we will be buying these upgrades on our Warriors to make them a bit stronger. Remember, the Vision of Palantir is able to boost the movement speed of the units, including your cavalry units. That this way, you can catch the enemy Gondonites or Rohirrim. Industry to get the money a bit faster. Again, Isengard needs a lot of cash. Like, just the armory costs you 1200, you know? And then every upgrade has to be purchased. And after that, you also need to buy the upgrades on your units. So, long story short, it's, you know, expensive to play the Isengard faction. Until you get to the mid game, in which you have industry from the spellbook, devastation, eventually fuel the fires. This way you can get so much money that you should have never ever money problems anymore. Okay, let's capture this one. There we go. Porcupine formation to defend this settlement. We have used the Palantir, so our Warriors, they will outrun the Rohirrim. That's why the Rohan player is microing around now. And our Lurtz is on the hand. Eventually, we will be able to catch Tyrion, but he is just getting in safety. There is a troll cage. Troll layer, I mean. We can creep this with Lurtz and get almost level 5. Tyrion. So lucky. But we actually put so much pressure. And again, you see what's happening? We are drawing them from our side of the map. And even Gondor now has to come to help his ally. Oh, our ally might actually use the Tainted Land eventually. I mean, we have the Carnage. Please, Tainted Land. It's a little bit too late. Not even needed, but it's fine. And he was barely able to save the Gondonites, which is also not the worst case. Because again, pressure is always great. Now we will be also able to destroy eventually a level 3 farm, which is amazing. We, of course, have to make a transition into the combos, like Crossbowman, Uruk-hai, and also the Pikeman. Because this is kind of your primary army as Isengard. Please die. There we go, nice. Level 4. Let's use Carnage to take it down a bit faster. Carnage is on cooldown though. He might not be able to do it. Every upgrade purchased, that's good. Oh, I think we can't do it now, right? I don't know. No, he got the last hit. Are you kidding me? Oh, that's bad. Okay. We have so much money now. Holy guacamole. But it's fine. We will need the money. You see how much it takes to upgrade the combo fully? Nearly 2,000. Just to upgrade them from the banner up to the blades, you know? So money is always nice for Isengard. The more money you have, the better it is. Now, of course, that's what I was saying at the beginning of the game. They have the mobility advantage over us. That means they will always be able to hit and run. And it's very hard for us to catch them. To reach out to them. Let's focus Tyrion with all the towers. Tyrion is a very squishy hero, and when you focus him down with all the towers, look how much HP he's losing. So you need to manually click on every single tower and right click on Tyrion right after. As long as you can force Tyrion to retreat, the enemy units, they will lose a lot of leadership. Okay, he's coming now. They wanna actually attack me together. 3 Gondonites, Rohirrim archers, Tyrion, holy moly. But come at me, bro. Come at me, bro. I'm ready. Trust me on that one. I'm ready. Just chase the Rohirrim in the meantime. Lurtz is also on the hand. Wanna chase down this far, this Tyrion. He can't stop. We also need to take care of our base. In the meantime, our ally was able to recover, though. That's very important. That's nice. And we will just need a bit more pikemen. And again, we have full towers, like mentioned before. Towers are efficient, effective, and impactful. Hold on a second, let's use Porcupine Formation, demolish the tower in time to not get, you know, let him get experience. He will eventually lose a lot of the Gondonites here around this side. Hey, oh my goodness, I was not paying attention, sorry for that. Let's go back, Warriors, please. Okay, industry is available, let's use it right off the bat to get a bit more money. Oh, nice, we were able to save them, that's very important. Losing units, especially because they are so expensive to upgrade and to level up. It's always a bad thing. So try to not lose a full battalion. Make one more combo. And we need to go now. I mean, we gotta make a move now. I don't want the game to last too long. Until Gandalf comes. Tyrion gets eventually level 4 with the Glorious. What is he doing? He's sacrificing a level 4 Gondonite just to kill a settlement? That's bad. He lost a lot. Okay? What I'm trying to say is like you want to win against Gondor Rohan before they actually get to the late game in which they might be able to recruit many, many Trebuchet. Get eventually Glorious Charge with Tyrion. Get Gandalf on the field. And then Lurt is nice as a, you know, anti-hero, as a counter-hero, but he can't be everywhere. He is not nearly as mobile as Gandalf or Tyrion is. So they can switch target all the time. They can attack us. They can go back to Mordor. And it's hard for me to follow up all the time. That's why you need to put pressure. That's why we will now be building an outpost next to the Rohan's piece. And eventually build a siege works with the rams. We will try to make knock knock. Who is there? Isengard. Okay, so more units. Just, you know, always have a plan B. Like for the worst case scenario, imagine if you go for an attack. Now here's Nazgul, but Nazgul can't really do much. Imagine something goes so wrong. We lose, you know, every army we have. We are using now for the attack. What happens then if you have nothing to defend yourself? We need to actually help our ally, man. I think he can defend himself around this side. There is, yeah, Tyrion, Gandalf. Oh my goodness. Nazgul can't approach. There is no chance. He has even Eowyn. So Gandalf, Easter Light, Eowyn's Might is more than enough to burst down not only the Nazgul, but even the Witch King. So with that being said, we need to help him. The best thing what we can do is cripple down Gandalf. Umulkir Pen is coming up. That's a mistake, by the way. You need Troll Cage. They have no Trolls, not even Witch King. So far, we were not able to get any experience or PowerPoint, not PowerPoints. I mean, any leaderships from our ally, but that's fine. We will try to win this game regardless. Palantir to make them a bit faster. Siege Forks, Uruk Pit in a furnace. We also killed the Archer range level 1 before he got scattered to level 2. That's massive, by the way. That's going to delay his fire arrows big time. Cripple. Gandalf, you shall not move. Gandalf, I feel so bad for him. What is he doing? He can't trample my combos like that. Let's use Warchant to make them deal 50% more damage and 50% more armor. Heal has been used. So unless he has double heal, he will definitely lose the Gandalf there. Oh, my ally should be covering this. Please cover. Nice. Gandalf can't survive that. And Gandalf, ladies and gentlemen, Gandalf the White is Gandalf the Dead. And we have almost the power point, I mean the experience we need to get our lords with the leadership unlocked, which is awesome. And in the meantime, always keep focusing on the map control. And that's what the Warg Riders are good for. This way we can deny the opening team a lot of resource income. And the, you know, the losing a hero, especially an expensive hero like Gandalf, is pretty punishing. So basically you need to invest 6,000 to recruit him and 2,000, even more than that when he's higher level, to revive him. What is going on here? That means like nearly 8, even more than that, 1,000 of resources have to be invested. And if you can take down the enemy farms, it's always nice because he will not be able to collect that much money. And you get more money in the meantime, because what will happen is they will have to deal with their lost settlements first before they can reach out to our settlements on our side of the map. So long story short, it's a win-win situation. We have so much money now. Holy guacamole, guys. Like, we are rich in this game. We have almost the rain too. Oh, this guy is annoying. Don't kill my rams like that, dude. Okay. Hold ability. Oh, he will be able to take down the siege works, right? Oh, man. But we have one ram left, and one ram is all we need. Trust me on that one. It's all we need. Now we gotta make some knock-knock noises. And when it comes to prioritize a target, in this situation, I would always like to attack the Rohan castle, because Rohan's castle is not as tough and as tanky as the Gondor castle, you know? So you can definitely damage the Rohan castle a bit easier, especially when he has not many towers around. He can't fight this. There is no world. Like, he needs the assistance of his ally, because Rohirrim archers are great against monsters like trolls and also Nazguls and Witch King and heroes like Lurt, but they can't fight against combos. That's not possible. Their weakness is fire. So they are taking... There is Aragorn, Arathorn's son. Let's cripple him. Palantir to make him faster. Aragorn, you shall not move. We have also Freezing Rain. Alright, he got crippled down. Big commitment now. Lurt is almost level 5. But Aragorn is beefy. In the meantime, let's target his castle with the ram. Use Elven Wood, that's fine. We just step aside. And Freezing Rain now to deny him all the leadership he's getting from Aragorn and also from Tirin. Now let's try to kill King Elessa, but he has Anduril now. With Anduril, it's a different story. He's tankier. We have also War Chant, by the way. Heal, okay. Aragorn, man, is so tanky. You know, we can't kill him. Even with this many combos and Lord shooting him down at the same time. Just switch target and kill Rohirrim Marches now. Please get level 5 Lords already. There we go. Finally. Finally. And in the meantime, we were also able to break one part of the wall, which is huge. Now we can go inside the genes. And keep making and recruiting more units. And keep focusing on the map. Mowagears, the man of the east. Okay, my ally is actually making a move now. We have also a combo battalion inside our ally's castle. Just for the worst case scenario, he might eventually need some help. But remember, Gandalf has been taken down before. And Aragorn dies with the second cripple. And we can, you know, the thing is, you can even target the enemy towers from Rohan. Like the battle towers he's building up. Watch this. I can take them down with my combos. Which is not the case for the Gondor towers. They can only be targeted by either monsters like Mumakils and... Oh, no. By either Mumakils or Trolls. Or siege weapons like Ballistas, Trebuchet, Catapults, and so on. Let's go inside the genes. Mumakils are hitting like a truck. Eowyn, what you doing, Eowyn? You can't handle this much pressure. The shield maiden of Rohan is no more. And Mumakils are inside the genes from Gondor. Warten is on cooldown, but we have Lord leadership. I don't know if this is going to be enough. Let's cripple down the... Theorin, kill him. Die, Theorin. Nice. Lourdes has shown his quality. Unlike Faramir, he is worth every single penny of investment. He's a bit more expensive now in the patch 2.22. In 1.06, he used to cost only 1200. We increased the cost of Lourdes to 1400. And that doesn't change anything about his power. He's still the most cost efficient hero in the game by far. But a little bit more expensive. The Mowagears are actually dying quite easily. Where is the Witch King at? I don't know. We have lost the Lords though, which is very annoying. Let's use Industry for our allies, please, to make him a bit more rich. He needs one more troll to get the Troll Cage to level 2. For a Drummer Troll, Gandalf. Just finish off this Rohan Castle in the meantime. Like, level 3 farms are a bit tanky, but not tanky enough. Our combos are hitting like an absolute truck. And again, you know, against the power of Mordor and Isengard, there can be no victory, ladies and gentlemen. We have also Saruman on the field. That's dope. I mean, let's even put them inside the tower, maybe. You know what I'm saying? Like, finish off this castle. We have so much money, we can just buy the... Oh, Munda has left the game. So it's only the Rohan player left now. And what can he do against such a reckless seed? Let's send some rams to the Gondor base now too. And let's buy the castle at the bottom right side. We are so rich. We can fill it up with many, many furnaces at the same time. But it shouldn't be necessary. Rohan cannot turn this game around. Look at this. More rams are coming. Gandalf is doing nothing. Because he can't do anything. And Lourdes, definitely MVP of the army, has crippled Gandalf, Theorin, Eowyn, Aragorn. He has done so much work for us. And Arkurisan decides to ditch, and that's going to be it, ladies and gentlemen. GG, well played, Isengard, Mordor, very, very strong in the patch 2.22. I will see you next time. Until then, keep hitting like a truck, and as always, stay beyond standards. Peace out.